how you consider calm?
Okay.
Those now, are those people over there.
Wait a minute. You just went and we answered 100 questions.
No, I'm just want to say one quick thing.
We just answered 100 questions.
I know, but I just want one quick thing.
Okay.
The word Kemet is not found in the Bible. That's all I want to say, and I'm throwing that in the conversation.
Okay, now let's go back to the original conversation, because I'm gonna tell you the brothers can tap dance good around history, and the brothers can make all of these good, wonderful assumptions. But what I'm gonna go back to is, yes, we have names. So I'm gonna ask you, if you saying the people that was kicked out are you, who was kicked out?
Who was kicked out?
Who was kicked out?
Foreigners was kicked
who?
Out.
Who?
Semitic.
You don't know no names.
Now watch this.
Wait a minute. No,
I don't know no names. Yeah, and Matt is right.
That's
I don't know no names.
I know some names. I just
no. Matt
just,
knows the names.
I
don't know.
I just told you the people that were kicked out were these Hyksos who were ruling in a forest. Now again, one of the people that kicked that almost kicked out was the Hyksos Pharaoh, the Hyksos ruler of Pepi, and his army and his troops. Now these brothers have already said that Pharaoh, those Hyksos rulers, were not them. So if those the people that got kicked out, and you're saying you're not the people that got kicked out, how you gonna jump up and say that they are you, because it fits your narrative at the end of it?
No. I have never agreed to.
You just said you were the people that got kicked out, right?
Yes, I was.
You saying you were the people that got kicked out, right?
Yes.
So Amos kicked out Hyksos by the name of Pepi and his armies. Were you a Pepi and his armies?
And were you
oppressing Egyptians?
No, I did say for the camera.
Yes or no?
No, I'm saying for the camera, I never mentioned names.
But yes or no?
So, the answer would be no.
Okay. Well, okay, so if you not the people that got kicked out.
I'm just saying, I don't know the names of the people that got kicked out.
I just told you.
I don't, it could possibly be a Pepi. What happened to a Pepi and his people?
No, but what I'm asking you, brother, were you the people that got kicked out?
Yes, we were the people that got kicked out.
We're the people that got kicked out, the Hyksos rulers and their armies.
I don't know about the Hyksos rulers.
But
and
I showed you documentation, you showed nothing.
Let me ask this, because this is a discrepancy I got with the whole kicking out thing. When we originally started talking about it, I didn't know nothing. I still barely know little, but I didn't know nothing about this. But when we first talked about it, we talked about it as if it was a war, a battle. And yeah. I'm not sure if this is a Kemetic culture or not. But who fights battles and then ties people up and just walk them out into the desert and say, well, you got to just go that way? I mean, because we have two different, we got a one story that shows a war going on, which means bloodshed, and we got one story with people tied with ropes behind their back, hands behind their back, roped up, and just sent on somewhere. Where were they sent to? There's something wrong with the story of the expulsion of the Hyksos.
Yeah, y'all verse.
Now,
so what happened? Were they roped up?
Did they whoop up?
When they got kicked out?
But you
if
just
Hyksos,
wait a minute. You missing the point. Wait a minute. But just so
that's
you
now,
just
they
said
got kicked out, right?
You just said that's not you. So why are you talking about what happened to the Hyksos?
I never said it was or wasn't me.
So were you the Hyksos of Pepi and his armies?
No, we
again.
Were.
No, yes,
I
know.
Never said a Pepi.
I'm
you're
asking
putting
you.
Names on
that's
it. I don't have names to give.
All right, I'm gonna slow down. I'm gonna do this slowly.
Okay.
We have the name of the last Hyksos Pharaoh that got kicked out. So I'm gonna
that
ask
got
you,
kicked out of Kemet.
Yes.
From
so I'm gonna ask you specifically. We have documentation of a Hyksos Pharaoh by the name of Pepi and his armies being kicked out.
Now,
wait a minute.
Okay, go ahead.
Is that you?
I don't know. I can't answer that question right now.
So how are you saying? So why would you ask? If you saying that the people that got kicked out, you don't even know if that's you, but then you say the people that got kicked out, they went over here and did this, so that gotta be us.
No, but
that
I'm
makes
asking
no sense.
You. I'm asking you, according to the Egyptian text, the word kicked out gotta come with another sentence. What happened to those people when they got kicked out?
What I'm saying. If you're not admitting that you're the people that got kicked out, who cares?
No, we are saying you're the people that got kicked out.
Just, man, bro, this is what I think me and this brother are saying. We can't agree fully with the Egyptian story. I don't believe that the Kemetic story is telling the full truth of the matter. That's my problem. Because in one essence, we're talking about like a war going on, but then in another relief, you got people just getting sent out into the desert.
Really?
I don't know.
So we're not even going to just
But again, can you answer?
The people
I
we're talking about.
Can you verify what happened to those people that got kicked out of a forest? What happened to those Semitic people?
This the, I'm saying the comedic story is unbalanced. It sounds like two different stories. Of course I believe, you know I believe it tonight, but I'm just saying.
How is the comedic story unbalanced?
I'm saying because if there's a war, how do you, after the war's over, rope people up and send them out? And then,
what are they supposed to do?
Kill them. What do you do in war?
Yeah, they kill some of them, but you want them to just murder everybody?
No, I don't want them to murder everybody, but after you subdue, after you subdue the army, you can still use them like everybody else does all over Africa. Use them as captive workers and slaves.
See, this what I'm not gonna let the brothers do. Y'all keep asking me. Y'all keep asking me what happened to the people after they got kicked out. And what I'm saying,
I ain't got an answer for that, brother.
Because wait a minute. Oh no. We're not gonna say that. I just haven't went in my bag yet. But what I'm first explaining is, if you're not admitting that you're the people that got kicked out, who cares what happened to the people that aren't you?
Okay, let me explain something.
First, admit you the people that got kicked out.
No. Hold on.
That's what I was saying.
They the ones that got kicked out, kid. What are you talking about?
The army got kicked out.
I don't get what y'all talking about.
Watch this. How could an army? If I'm a warrior and I come at another warrior, and now because other warriors have defeated my kind, he gonna just rope me up and tell me to walk that way. We still warriors. I'm still at war. I don't get that. How do we get kicked out instead of getting killed?
Now, see, this is now family. You gotta listen to this, family. What Matt is trying to do is get me to pinpoint a group. A person, a pharaoh. I have said, and I will say again for the video, Moses is not Moses' real name. Crazy, I'm not going to say I know the name.
Y'all sound crazy. Man.
I'm not going to say I know the name.
So, all right,
Did every
Asiatic get kicked out when the Hicksos got kicked out?
No.
Wait a minute. What I'm telling you is, brother, it was certain Asiatics that got forced out.
Certain ones that got forced out.
So, what I'm saying is.
My book says certain ones left.
So, listen to me, brother. So were you the ones that got kicked out?
I was the ones that got kicked out, but that doesn't mean
minute.
I'm the ones that you're talking about. It could be another group.
We're talking about the Hicksos.
But there could be another group of people that left. It don't necessarily got
to
be the exact group that left. My book says that they left. He's saying that we got kicked out, and he's trying to pinpoint
Does your book say it was a war?
My book says it was a war. It was the Egyptians versus God's people.
It was a war in Egypt and before they got kicked out.
And then I pulled papyrus.
Does your book say it was a war in Egypt and then they got kicked out?
Yes, my book says that. My book says that they went to war and they left. They went to war with God's people and they left.
After Moses
The Egyptian text says we whooped they behind and kicked them out. The Bible says that we left. But no matter what, whether we use the Egyptian text or the biblical text, they both left. You can't tell me that there wasn't a group of Semitic people that left Kemet. You are saying there was a group of Semitic people that left Kemet. Now, watch this. You're saying it based on your Egyptian text. I'm saying it based on my Hebraic Bible. But the fact is they both Semitic people left Kemet. You want me to put a name on it. I can't give you a name.
Listen what I'm telling you. Just follow my logic, brother. We know who got kicked out. It's not a mystery.
No, what happened to those people?
Wait a minute. But you're not even admitting that you're them. No, so who cares?
I did admit that we are the people that got kicked out. Those people.
Stop.
Because I don't know those people that got kicked out. I'm saying a group
of people that got kicked out or not?
Israelites
got, because what you're saying is, what we talking about today is Hyksos being the Israelites. So you saying that Israelites came into Egypt as Hyksos and got kicked out as Israel.
As Hyksos. And went and dwelled in
a land.
But
you're saying that the Israelites are Hyksos.
Yes, we're saying that the Israelites are.
Okay, so when the 70
foreign,
came in.
But again, what is Hyksos? The Israelites were
gotta
a
be
foreign
Israelites.
Group of people. No, it does not got to be Israelites.
I mean, that's what we talk about
today.
No, it
does not.
Hyksos
immigrants is
Israelites.
Not just Mexicans. It's immigrants is Chinese. Immigrants is Africans. Immigrants are Mexicans.
Watch this. Mexicans can be Latinos. Dominicans can be Latinos. Spanish people can be.
Yes, you can.
born as Spanish, but you know what I'm saying? Brazilians can be Latinos. So Latino.
Here's the question I want to know. Are the Hyksos Israelites, or did they become Israelites when they got kicked out?
The Hyksos became the nation of Israelites.
Okay, so that's not Israel. That's not Israel in Kemet if they became Israel.
No, a family. A few of less than 100 people went into Israel as Hyksos, which means they went into Israel, Kemet, as immigrants. A group went into Kemet as immigrants. That group grew and they left Kemet, or got kicked out of Kemet, or had a war with Kemet. They left and dwelt in a land called Israel, and they was considered Israelites.
Became Israelites after that?
It was only a family. It was never a nation that went into Kemet.
Okay, so you're saying they was considered, we were just gonna call them Israelites after they got expelled, or?
Let's put it like this. During the time of the expulsion, they would not have been known as Israelites. They wouldn't have been known as Israelites.
That's just
the
not
family
lying
is
up
Israel. Story,
man.
What you mean it's not lining up?
It's not lining up with your book.
So the question is, what's not lining up?
Israel going into Egypt and being enslaved. Hyksos were rulers.
But I got a relief showing Hyksos and Asiatics being tied up as captives.
The story is in Exodus chapter 1, Blackburn.
No, it's not in Exodus. That's what you're not understanding.
That's what it says.
That's not the story of Israel going into Kemet. The story of Israel going into Kemet started in Genesis chapter 40.
Let me see that in Exodus book, man.
It starts in Genesis chapter 40. Now, would you accept the relief from Hamotep's tomb that shows Asiatics?
Blackburn, I'm finna read your book.
In what chapter?
When the 70 souls went in.
When the 70 souls went in. Now, let me ask you this. Do your Egyptian text, would you agree with Hamotep's tomb? In a relief in
Hamotep. Ain't no Hamotep, bro. What you doing, man?
Hotep too.
Slow down, man. he tried to slide that in.
Hey, that's
man.
What I'm saying. That's why I don't do the names.
I gotta watch this. I gotta watch him, man.
That's why I don't do the names. Would you agree with a relief in the tomb? Would you agree with the release? Do you consider that to be history? Do you consider that to be Kemetic and Egyptian history? A relief in a tomb. Yes or no?
A relief in a tomb?
Hey, in other words, a communication in a tomb as a relief. Do you consider that to be Egyptian Kemetic history? It's a yes or no, okay, so if you consider that to be Egyptian and Kemetic history, I'm gonna do something for the camera. I'm going to show a particular piece, a relief from an Egyptian tomb. And you describe to me, after I show it to the camera, I want you to describe to me what you see.
This is a relief. Hopefully the camera can see it. This is a relief of Hyksos and Asiatics coming in ancient Kemet as slaves and merchants. This is in the tomb. It's in museums all over the world, but it's also painted inside of a tomb.
I'm gonna show this to Ricky. I'm gonna show it to Matt and Corey. I want you to tell me, when you look at this relief, what do you see? These are Asiatic Hebrews. Do you agree with that? Do you think that's forgery? Do you agree with this particular relief?
That's not an Israelite.
Okay. Now you said yourself that Asiatic is Semitic people, right?
Yeah, that Semitic people call themselves what we know.
Now Hebrews are. Would you consider Hebrews to be Semitic people?
They from that same. I get what you're saying. I understand.
Okay, so if we got Semitic people coming into Kemet as slaves, and we got Semitic people coming into Kemet as merchants, how could we possibly say that we got your Egyptian text nails down the group of people that came in and out of Kemet? We got a group of people called the Asiatics. That's Semitic. That could be a wide range of groups of
how
people.
So how many races are in the Asiatics? How many ethnicities?
It's not one.
I understand that. That's why I'm asking you how many. You say it's Israelites.
I got to get you that information.
Just give me some names. Give me some names of who you think.
Hittites,
Ishmaelites, are they Israelites?
No.
So now what I want you to do, I want you to explain to the people how you know that's an Israelite.
I can't explain to the people that's
so
an Israelite.
So why can you use that to prove that Israelites came in?
Because I got a biblical text that I agree with. How can you
hear me?
My biblical text agrees with the relief.
That works.
Your Kemetic text agrees with the relief.
Do you know what that relief is showing?
What is it showing?
I'm asking you that.
Yes, I'm sure it's showing the Kemetic people. I'm sure it's showing the Semitic people coming into Kemet. That's what it's showing.
It's showing Israelites. It's showing
Semitic people coming into Kemet.
What the Bible say? Who the Bible Semitic, say came in?
Semitic people.
Israelites, children of Jacob, came in.
Yes, which is Semitic
70
people.
70 souls.
Is this Semitic people?
Do you believe that they were the first? Man. You believe that they were the first group of Semitic people to walk into Kemet?
No.
Exactly. So. So it could have been a wave of Hyksos coming in. So they just considered them
so
all
the same. So what I'm asking for now, I get the theory. Right. Now what I'm trying to say is, prove to me that these are Israelites.
It works both ways. We can't unprove it or prove it.
I can't prove that.
I'm saying we can't prove that's not. The only thing we can do is look at the clothes, but we can't say, oh, that's Israelite clothing because they got the stripes and the brown stripes. No.
So that's what I'm saying.
Well,
so
we can't say that.
I'm agreeing with that because that's what our text describes.
Yeah, exactly.
So the text describes that's on that relief right there.
Yes.
That's Joseph coming in, Kemet.
It don't describe as Joseph coming in. It describes Semitic people coming into Kemet, and it describes
It'd
Semitic
be different
people
if the Kemetic walls never said nothing Kemet. Like Semitic people have never walked through our, you know, like if there was some
So
kind
you
of
telling me
wall
just
up.
So you telling me that just because you have people that are considered Asiatics, that was able to come into Egypt, leave Egypt, and come back in, and the Bible says that Joseph went in and his family and 70 souls, that proves that that story
it's
is correct?
Not
that ain't no
way.
Wait a
second.
That,
it's
man.
Not
wait
historically
hey,
now,
these guys
they
just said that they can't prove
it. They can't prove
it. No, wait a second. Hold on. Let's be fair here.
That's what
let's
I'm saying.
Be fair.
As long as you can't prove
now,
it.
Let's be fair. Let's call it Semitic people. Semitic people, according to both sides of the field, went into Kemet. Semitic people, according to both sides of the field, got kicked out of Kemet.
When does that tomb date to?
I give you the date. I can give it to you right now.
Dude, can you give it to me? So how y'all bringing evidence? This real talk, man. How you bringing this evidence and you claiming it's your history? Nah, I'm being serious, Kenfo. How you claiming it's your history and you don't even got all the facts?
Because you're fighting against the facts.
No, I'm not.
Yes, you are. You're fighting against Semitic people
coming in.
I'm asking
you a
simple
question.
You have agreed already that Semitic people came in.
So listen to me. Listen to the question good. Mm-hmm. When did this happen? When did Joseph come in?
I can't give you a date.
No,
I can give you a date later.
When did Joseph come in?
Came in 200 years prior to the Exodus.
No, I'm asking what chronological time period did Joseph come in?
200 some years prior to the Exodus.
When
do you
is
think
that
the Kemetic?
Okay, so stop. Okay, so I can mathematically deduce that if you tell me when did the Exodus happen?
Around 12, 13.
Okay.
So
the Exodus was supposedly like 930 years.
Slow down.
Before,
wait a minute. Slow down. Wait a minute.
Solomon
wait, we're going to deal with this
so
one at a time. Wait a minute.
Yeah.
Because y'all going to jump around. Wait a minute. Y'all, how long will y'all, you say that Joseph came in 200 years before the Exodus?
A couple of hundred years.
Now, I'm going to show you how stuff can sound good until you time down. So if the Exodus happened, right, around 1200 something, right?
Somewhere in that time period.
It doesn't matter. You're going to be off. And you say that Joseph came in about, wait a minute, no. I know y'all gonna disagree, y'all have no choice, but we gonna dead each point as we get to it.
But you asked first, us to put a date on something.
He just did, let me deal
yeah,
with his date.
No, you
can't clean it up until
no,
I destroy
but,
it.
But wait a second,
Stop.
Wait a second. No, because I said in the beginning of the video that I don't have dates and names.
You just gave me a date.
No, I gave you a date.
Stop before the video go out, because I'm gonna deal with this. Y'all not gonna get it, you're not gonna run. You can run after I do this to you.
Okay.
Out of love. Okay. The brother said.
It's still love and fellowship, brothers.
Yeah. No, we good. The brother said the Exodus was around 12 something, right? And he said that the Israelites.
And Carl disagreed.
Stop. Just stop.
Okay.
Just stop.
But Carl disagreed.
Discipline, brother.
Okay. Cool.
Discipline. Because you know what I'm finna do. You know it's
yeah,
gonna be,
I know.
You know
I
it's
know
gonna
that.
Be good. Okay. The brother said that the Exodus was around 12 something. And he said the Israelites came in around 200 years before that.
Right.
So that would that would take us back to around 1400 and something. Do we all agree with that math? Now, the tomb inscription that this brother just showed, I do know the date. We talking about around 1900 BCE. I'm talking about 500 years prior to when this brother is saying the Israelites came in. So if that tomb inscription is 1800, 1900 BCE, and now he's telling me that the Israelites came in at around 1400 BCE, 500 years later, 500 years later, how is he gonna tell you people that bar relief or that tomb relief shows the Israelites coming in. That's crazy. That's 500
years. Wait a second. Wait a second.
I haven't said that. I haven't said that. Because
I'm about to go off on that point.
I haven't said that. We came here today so y'all can prove that the Hyksos were Israelites, and you two just said that you cannot prove.
Well, wait a second. So, no, I'm going to deal with that one, too. I'm going to deal with that one.
I've been letting y'all boys go.
Y'all
go
ahead.
Man. Go ahead.
I mean,
I'm going to deal with that one, too.
Both of you guys just admitted that you cannot prove it, and then you said that you can't disprove it. But you came here today to prove that the Israelites were Hyksos.
Okay, now hold on. Let me
have
go ahead,
one,
Corey,
one second. Look. I proved this from the first, from my first statement, my opening statement, which was Hyksos is just a label. The Israelites had to have been considered Hyksos, if not whatever the word for Asiatic was. But we're talking about foreign rulers, foreigners, shepherd kings, whatever little term you want to give to it. The Israelites would have been able to be classified as Hyksos. That's simple.
But you say you cannot prove it.
Now, I cannot prove that the people on that relief were Jacob and his family. See what I'm saying?
So
the reason I'm showing it is because I'm trying to disprove your narrative as slaves and merchants, that
the Hyksos people was not, your narrative say Hyksos people was never enslaved. That relief totally disagrees with that. What? That relief totally disagrees. That relief I just showed.
It was
that
always
you just
slavery
said,
in Egypt.
Okay,
it was
so
always
you
slavery
said,
all
you
over
said
the world.
Yourself that Hyksos was never enslaved. The relief just disproved that.
Again, do you even know what that brother, you better be careful. I'm actually one more time before I go into it. Do you even know what that display is showing, fam?
It's showing slaves and merchants.
Who possessed those what you're calling slaves? Who
if you look at the whole Pharaoh king.
Fam, you're wrong.
No, you're wrong. And I will show it to you.
It was an Asiatic bringing in offerings. If that displayed captive, it was an Asiatic bringing in captive.
I disagree with
but
that
100%. But that determinative that they trying to say is captive, the person with the arms behind his back, that could just display enemy or a foreigner. But what I'm saying is it was an Asiatic bringing them in. So if they were slaves, they were slaves to the Asiatic bringing them in.
Totally disagree. The whole research. You saw a
research the relief.
That's a servant, so that would
research the relief.
Now I agree with Matt. You got to research that relief.
That's what I'm saying. That's what I'm saying, brother. You trying to
see for Semitic people to come in with some man.
And that's exactly what the relief showed.
Now hold on. Let me tell you what I came here to
wait a minute. Wait a minute. Wait a minute.
You gotta have a discipline. All
right, go ahead.
Now, Rick just said we came here to prove that the Hyksos were Israelites. We've done that. You just don't know we've done that. Let me tell you how I've done that. You yourself said that the Semitic people was Hyksos, correct?
No. The Hyksos were a mix of people of Semitic and...
Okay, so if Semitic people was under the umbrella of Hyksos... Would you agree with that statement? It's a mixed group of people. The Hyksos is a mixed group of people that has Semitic people in it, right?
They were a mixed.
Okay, so if the Hyksos had Semitic people, if they had
Israelites are,
if they had Semitic people,
you just said you can't prove it.
No, I'm asking you. I'm going. Hold on. I'm going by what Rick just said.
Hyksos were Israelites.
Okay, can you?
That's what we came here.
Matt, come on, Matt. Can you give me some discipline
on
your boy?
Okay, my bad. Go ahead.
Can you give me some discipline on your boy?
He's asking him questions.
He ain't let me ask. If you're saying that the Hyksos people were also Semitic, right? In that group of Hyksos was Semitic people, right? Do you agree that the Hebrews are Semitic people, right?
I don't know that. If they are or not.
Okay. Do you agree that the Hyksos was a group of people that was Semitic? I'm telling you, Hebrews are Semitic people, correct?
Okay, I give you that. I agree.
Okay, so
if
the Hyksos is a group of a large, different groups of people, and in that large groups of people, you have Semitic people, that by definition would say that Israelites are Semitic people that came in through the Hyksos umbrella.
Good.
Can I jump in for
and
a second?
And you admitted that you can't.
Okay.
Can I jump in for a second?
But you have to agree. Yeah. I'm going to give you just one second. You got to agree that Hebrews and Semitic people are one of the same.
I don't know that.
Okay.
Now, okay. Now,
I want. I gotta come back and get you.
I wanna recap. I wanna recap a few things. Okay. Because what we have to do is people can say a lot of stuff that sound good, but we have to see if it actually makes sense. Okay. So I wanna remind you guys that the brother used a tomb relief from around 1800, 1900 BCE to prove and said that that was proof of the Israelites coming in. Then the brother told us that Joseph, the Israelite, came in around 1400 BCE. I want y'all to be mindful of that. So that point that he used, with that bar relief trying to prove Israelites coming in, totally destroyed that. That's not evidence. That's not proof. Now I want to deal with this, because either the brother gonna give this date up, or we just gonna keep banging and banging and banging away. Y'all heard earlier in the conversation, and I made sure they said it several times so you can rewind it and hear it, but the brothers kept saying that this expulsion is the Exodus, right? When the Hyksos got expelled, they're saying that they got expelled as well, right? Now, we do have dates on this stuff. The Hyksos got expelled, family, in around 1550 BCE. Then the brother slipped up and said that the Exodus happened around 12-something BCE. So his story does not even make sense. You cannot have the Exodus happening at 1550 BCE and the Exodus also happening at 1250 BCE. So what I'm showing y'all is, although they're jumping around and although they're trying to mix and match and piece things together and make a puzzle piece that makes sense, when you start tying down dates and you start tying down different dynasties, and when you start putting names to these people, you can see it don't make no sense. So I want to ask the brother something real quick.
Okay.
If you're saying now that the Exodus happened at around 1250 BCE, does that contradict your earlier statement that the Exodus occurred during the time of the expulsion at around 1550 BCE? Did you just contradict yourself, brother?
Absolutely not, because I said in the very beginning of the video, I don't have dates and I don't have names. I will happily give you a precise date, because my precision, I could be 200 years out possibly.
So you have no dates?
No, I said that in the beginning of the video.
I was going somewhere. So the brother has no dates, yet he confidently yelled out around 12-something BCE. I want y'all to understand that. So we do know that the brother will make stuff up. Now I love you, but I gotta go here, because we doing this. So now we know the brother just shooting from the hip, making dates up off the
can't
top.
Can't shoot from the hip if I said I don't got it.
But you gave it. You shouldn't have gave it.
You pressed for a date, so I just threw something out there.
You shot from the hip. You made it up.
Now, again,
wait a minute. I wanted to do it. You just started going. The brother admitted he has no dates, but then the brother, to try to make a point, the brother gave us a date.
Okay.
And that date was totally destroyed, showing that he may be telling you some stuff that may sound good, but the brother's not accurate on a lot of his information. What I want to ask is, if y'all have no dates, if y'all do not know when the Israelites came into Egypt, if they came in, don't know when the Israelites left, if the Israelites ever left, how are you coming here to dispute me and Ricky about the Israelite history when you don't even know your own history, because you don't know when none of this stuff happened?
I got to keep this in mind, what it just said, because I got to come
quick.
Back on that.
I just wanted to get this out real quick. All I'm trying to do is give y'all the understanding that Hyksos is a label, and Hyksos means Semitic people mixed with Asiatic, mixed Asiatic origin. So let's see what the Most High said Israel was. This, you can take it as metaphor or whatever. Ezekiel 16:2 says, "Son of man, cause Jerusalem to know her abominations, and say, thus said the Lord God unto Jerusalem, your birth and your nativity is of the land of Canaan. Your father was an Amorite and your mother a Hittite." That's mixed Semitic origin. You can't say Israelite is not a Hyksos. He's Semitic and he's mixed with Asiatic.
And he's a foreigner.
And he's a foreigner.
That travels. That's a definition of Hyksos.
Did every Asiatic in the world go into Egypt during the time of the Hyksos?
Nope.
So how are you so sure that you even went in if you were there?
Okay,
y'all have no proof of nothing, but go ahead, bro.
Okay, now let's get back to what I said at first. I got no dates. my Hebrew brother even disagree with the dates. That's why I said from the beginning, and I know how Matt operates. Matt is very, particular on making you stick to a date, stick to a name. I'm not gonna give him that right now. I will go and research that, but I can't give him a date or a name. But what I can give, I'm sorry, I said I. What we all can give is that Hyksos is a Semitic people. All of us will say, amen, pastor, which I'm not, but anyways. We can say that they got kicked out. We can also say that they dwelt in the land of Israel.
That boy just read from Ezekiel. Ezekiel was just a dream.
Ezekiel was not a dream. Ezekiel was a prophet.
A vision.
That was not no prophet.
Wake up, man. Wake up.
Ezekiel.